I'm the gypsy girl.
Now, soldiers burst into a bakery. They find gypsies hiding under the floor.
10 pieces of silver for the gypsy Esmeralda.
The people stand chained together. On a hillside, Phoebus and Frollo watch soldiers push a colorful wagon into the river. Several people come up out of the water for air.
20 pieces of silver for the gypsy Esmeralda. Take them away.
Phoebus shakes his head. By a thatched cottage, Frollo's horse and soldiers wait. Townspeople watch. Esmeralda and Jolly wear their disguise.
He's never harmed anyone.
Frollo's gone mad. We found this gypsy talisman on your property. Have you been harboring gypsies?
Our home is always open to the weary traveler. Have mercy, my lord.
I am placing you and your family under house arrest until I get to the bottom of this. If what you say is true and you're innocent, then you have nothing to fear.
But we are innocent. I assure you, we know nothing of these gypsies.
Frollo bars the family inside the cottage. Speaking to Phoebus, he mounts his horse.
Burn it.
What?
Until it's murders, these people are traitors and must be made examples of.
With all due respect, sir, I was not trained to murder the innocent.
But you were trained to follow orders.
Glaring, Phoebus backs toward the cottage. He extinguishes a lit torch in a barrel of water.
Insolent coward.
Frollo takes a torch from a soldier and walks his horse forward. He lights a windmill and flames engulf the cottage. As a windmill sail falls, Phoebus dodges it. He jumps into the cottage as Esmeralda watches from afar. Phoebus emerges carrying 2 small children. The man and woman follow him. Reaching safety, the grateful couple take their children. From behind, a soldier knocks Phoebus down and grabs him.
The sentence for insubordination is death. Such a pity. You threw away a promising career.
Consider it my highest honor, sir.
A soldier raises a sword, and Esmeralda flings a rock at the horse, who throws off Frollo. Phoebus punches the soldiers, mounts the horse, and rides away. As he crosses a bridge, soldiers shoot dozens of arrows. One hits Phoebus's back, and he falls off the horse into the river. Out of view, Esmeralda hurries down the bank.
Don't waste your arrows! Let the traitor rot in his watery grave! Fight the girl! You have to burn the city to the ground, so be it.
Hiding by the bottom of the bridge, Esmeralda watches the soldiers march away, then rushes to the water's edge. Jumping in, she plunges underwater. She comes back up, clutching Phoebus's limp form, and drags him through the waves. At sunset, dark plumes of smoke rise from buildings burning throughout the city. On horseback, Frollo meets soldiers on a cobbled street.
Everywhere
and still no sign of the gypsy girl.
The entire cathedral was surrounded. Guards at every door. There was no way she could have escaped. Unless...
He looks at the bell tower. At a ledge, Laverne and Victor gaze out.